Welcome to an example of simple harmonic motion of a spring. An object is attached to a coiled spring. It is pulled down a distance of 20 centimeters from its equilibrium position and released. The time for one complete oscillation is 4 seconds. So to model this, we're starting with an object on a spring, as we see here. It's pulled down 20 centimeters below the equilibrium point and then released. So it goes up to a height that would be 20 centimeters above the equilibrium point, and then back down to the starting position of 20 centimeters below the equilibrium point. So the object starts here, moves up, and then back down, and this cycle or oscillation takes 4 seconds. So we want to find the equation to model the position at time t, determine the position at 1.2 seconds, and determine the frequency. So to find the equation, we'll first graph the function, and then from the graph determine the equation. So because at time t equals 0, the object is 20 centimeters below the equilibrium point, we're going to say the displacement is negative 20 at time t equals 0, which would be this point here. Then after 2 seconds, which is half of the oscillation time, it would be up here at a high point, which would be 20 centimeters above the equilibrium point, which means the point 2, positive 20, would be a point on our function, which would be this point here. Then after 4 seconds, it returns to the low point, which is 20 centimeters below the equilibrium point, which would be this point here. And then since it takes 2 seconds to reach the high point from here to here, at 1 second it'd be halfway between or at the equilibrium point. So the function would also contain the point 1, 0, or this point here, as well as the point 3, 0, which would be halfway between the high point and the low point for the second half of the oscillation. So now we'll graph the trig function that will model this simple harmonic motion. Hopefully we recognize this resembles the cosine function because it starts at a minimum rather than at the midline. So let's take this graph on the next slide to find the equation. This is the same equation using some graphing software. Again, our goal is to find the equation of this function using one period or one oscillation, which would be this piece here. And again, because it resembles the basic cosine function, or this function here, we use a form of this equation here to find the equation of the function. We could use the sine function, but then we'd also have to have a phase shift or a shift right in order to find the equation. So because we're using the cosine function, our graph does not have to be shifted left or right, which means d would be 0. And also notice the midline is the x-axis, so we don't have a vertical shift or vertical translation, so c is equal to 0 as well. So to find the equation of our graph, we're going to use the form y equals a cosine bx. But because we want our function to be d of t, we'll use the form d of t equals a times cosine bt. Let's do a quick review of how a and b affect the graph of the basic cosine function. The absolute value of a is the amplitude. Remember, if a is negative, we also have a reflection across the x-axis. To find the value of b, 2 pi divided by b must equal the period of the function. And again, we already said c and d would be 0 in our case. So going back to our graph, notice how the distance from the midline to the maximum, or the distance from the midline to the minimum, is 20, which means the absolute value of a must equal 20. But notice for our function at t equals 0, we have a minimum, and for the basic cosine function, when x is 0, we have a maximum, which means our graph has been reflected across the x-axis, and therefore a isn't positive 20, a is negative 20. So now we know the value of a. To determine the value of b, since one oscillation, or the period, is equal to 4 seconds, 4 must be equal to 2 pi divided by b. So to solve this equation for b, we'll multiply both sides by b. So we have 4b equals 2 pi, divide both sides by 4. So we have b equals 2 pi divided by 4, or pi over 2. So this is all we need to write our equation. We now know that d of t must equal negative 20 times cosine of b times t, or pi over 2 times t. So pi t divided by 2. Now we have the equation that models the position at time t. We can answer the last two questions. The next question is determine the position at 1.2 seconds, which means we want to evaluate the function d of t at t equals 1.2. So d of 1.2 is going to be equal to negative 20 times cosine of pi over 2 times t, which would be pi over 2 times 1.2. So now we'll go to the calculator to determine this approximate value. We need to make sure that we are in radian mode. So press the mode key. Notice how in the third row it is in radian mode. So go back to the home screen and type in negative 20 cosine. Then we have pi over 2 times 1.2. So the position at 1.2 seconds is approximately 6.18 centimeters. And because it's positive, that means it's going to be approximately 6.18 centimeters above the midline. If we take a look at the graph, notice that when t is 1.2, the function value is approximately 6.18, which would be this point here. The last question is to determine the frequency. The frequency is the reciprocal of the period. So looking at our graph, we already recognize that the period, the time it takes for one oscillation, is 4 seconds. Well, 4 is equal to 4 over 1. Therefore, the reciprocal would be 1/4. So the frequency would be 1/4 of an oscillation per second. That's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.